Dots is the new way of writing game code. It enables us to make extremely performant games, but getting started with it can be difficult. There are actually a lot of things you need to get going. So in this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to set up a Dots project correctly. But keep in mind that because Dots is still experimental and under heavy development, some things will probably change in the future. For this tutorial, I'm using Unity 2020.1.9 F1. I'm just gonna make a small demo scene here with some cubes falling down. The first thing we need to do is to enable preview packages in the project settings. For this, go to Window and Package Manager to open up the Package Manager. Then click on the little gear icon in the top right corner and select Advanced Project Settings. Now enable preview packages. The first package you should install is the Hybrid Renderer package. For this, click on the plus in the top left corner of the package manager and then add package from git URL. Then paste in this string. I'll also supply it in the video description. This will also install all other necessary Dots related packages. With all the Dots packages now installed, we can convert the game objects to entities. For this, I will make them part of a subscene. As you can see, we now have the same scene just without game objects. But you will notice that the cubes no longer fall to the ground. For this, we will need the Unity Physics package. For this, click on the plus in the top left corner of the package manager and then add package from git URL. Then paste in this string. I'll also supply it in the video description. With it now installed, all the cubes behave correctly again. Now the Hybrid Renderer package currently has version 1 and version 2. Version 1 is currently the default and will work with the built-in rendering pipeline, but is no longer in active development. Therefore, you should consider switching to version 2. But version 2 only supports the universal rendering pipeline and high definition rendering pipeline. To switch to the hybrid rendering package version 2, we will need to switch our rendering pipeline. Here I will show you how to get going with the universal rendering pipeline. If you want to use the high definition rendering pipeline instead, you'll have to look for instructions yourself. The first thing we need to do is to install the universal rendering pipeline package to our project. For that, go to the package manager, search for Universal RP and click install. Then go to the project panel and create a new pipeline asset. This will create two assets. The last thing to do is to go to Edit and Project Settings and assign the pipeline asset to the scriptable rendering pipeline settings slot under the Graphics tab. Great, now you are using the universal rendering pipeline. If your scene went pink, that only means that we need to update the materials to universal materials. For that, go to Edit, Rendering Pipeline, Universal Rendering Pipeline and click on Upgrade Project Materials to Universal RP Materials. Now we only need to tell the hybrid renderer to use version 2. For this, go back to the project settings and under player search for scripting defined symbols. Add the following string. You will see a message in your console informing you that version 2 is now active. Now, in order to enable build support for Dots projects, we will need some other packages. These are all the packages names you will need to add. Add them either via the package manager UI by clicking add package from git URL or by adding them directly in the package.json manifest file. You will also need build configuration files for each of your platforms you plan to build for. If you then want to make a build, just click build in the top right corner. Something else you might want to install is the Dots Editor package. This package provides tools to make Dots development easier. For this, edit via the following URL. You can open up these tools by going to Window, Dots, then Entities and Systems. Now your project is all set up for Dots development. Keep in mind that Dots is still under heavy development, so some things might change. If you get stuck, just look it up in the documentation. I hope this tutorial helped you in setting up a Dots project and start your Dots adventure. Thanks for watching.